of what will be, but rather what already is. We do not create this marriage because we cannot. But we can and do celebrate with Garrick, Amber, and their families the wonderful and joyous occurrence that's already taken place in their lives. Love has already been created, and it has grown between Amber and Garrick, leading them to this point today in their lives. The love that we speak of is amply defined in the writings of Paul in 1 Corinthians 13, which read, love is patient, love is kind, it does not envy, it does not boast, it is not proud, it does not dishonor others, it's not self-seeking, it's not easily angered, it keeps no record of wrongs, love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, and always perseveres. Love never fails. It is the wish of everyone here today, I'm sure, that your marriage brings each of you much happiness. But happiness in a marriage is not something that just happens. You must work at it. Remember to say I love you, to hold hands whenever you get a chance, and at no time take the other for granted. Family and friends, we are witness to the union of these two individuals who choose to commit to a life together as one. It is our responsibility as their friends and their family to provide them as a couple with our love, our support, and our approval. For the beauty around us, the strength it offers, and the peace it brings, we are indeed grateful and honored to be a part of the life that you two have chosen to live as husband and wife from this day forward. So Garrick, do you take this woman to be your wedded wife, love her, comfort her, honor and cherish her, forsaking all others through good times and bad, in sickness and health, so long as you both shall live? And Amber, do you take this man to be your wedded husband, to love him, to comfort him, to honor him, and keep him, forsaking all others, through good times and bad, in sickness and in health, for as long as you both shall live? Victor Hugo wrote, you can give without loving, but you can never love without giving. The great acts of love are done by those who are habitually performing small acts of kindness. We part the extent that we love. Love is knowing that even when you are alone, you'll never be lonely again. And great happiness of life is the conviction that we are loved. Loved for ourselves, and even loved in spite of ourselves. Please now focus on each other's hands as you stand there holding them together. For these are the hands of your best friend, young and strong and full of love for you, that are holding yours. Your wedding day, as you promise to love each other today, tomorrow, and forever. These are the hands that will work alongside yours as together you build your future. And these are the hands that will passionately love you and cherish you throughout all the years, and with the slightest touch will comfort you like none other. These are the hands that will hold you when fear or grief fill your mind. And these are the hands that will countless times wipe the tears from your eyes, tears of sorrow and tears of joy. These are the hands that will give you strength when you need it. And lastly, these are the hands that even when wrinkled in age will still be reaching for yours, still giving you the same unspoken tenderness with just a touch. May we have the ring, please. These are the rings that Amber and Garrick will wear the rest of their lives. So let us now bless these rings. May these rings be blessed as a symbol of this affectionate unity. These two lives are now joined in one unbroken circle. Wherever they go, may they always return to one another in their togetherness. May these two find in each other the love for which all men and women yearn. May they grow in understanding and in compassion. May the home which they establish together be such a place of sanctuary that many will find there a friend. May these rings on their fingers symbolize the touch of the spirit of love in the heart. Amen. Gary, can you take Amber's ring, place it upon her left hand ring finger. Please now repeat your vows to her. I, Gary, can take you, Amber.
I, Gary, can
be my wife, my partner in life, and my one true love. And now you'll take Garrick's ring, place it on his left hand ring finger. I am. Take you, Gary, to be my husband, my partner in life, and my one. Amber and Garrick have chosen to commemorate their union along with Devin, the celebration of the sand ceremony, if you'd like to approach the table. Today, as Eric and Amber have sealed their commitment to each other with the exchange of rings, they too make a commitment to Devin. The three vials of sand here represent Amber, Garrick, and Devin. As each pours in the sand, they show how the individual colors create a beautiful masterpiece of love and mutual respect. Just as the sands are forever intermixed, so are the lives of the people being celebrated here today. As we join this couple in marriage, we are also reminded of the significant role that Devin plays in this marriage. Today, a new unified life is shared within this family. From Mark 10:9, what therefore God hath joined together, let no man put asunder. Amber and Garrick, we've heard your promises to share your lives together. We recognize and we respect the vows that you've made here this day before each one of us as your witnesses. May the road rise to meet you. May the wind always be at your back. May the sun shine upon your face, the rain falls soft upon your fields, and until we meet again, may God hold you in the palm of his hand. May God be with you and bless you. May you see your children's children. And may the hand of a friend always be near. May green be the grass you walk on. May blue be the skies above you. And may pure be the joys that surround you. And may truth be the hearts that you love. In the honesty and sincerity of what you have said and done here today, by the joining of hands, the exchange of vows and rings, it gives me great privilege by the powers vested in me by the state of Alabama to pronounce you husband and wife. Garrick, for the first time, you can kiss your wife. Introduce for the first time, Mr. and Mrs. Garrick Myers.